In this example, we're going to look at two irreversible gas phase reactions, both first order and exothermic. We're going to carry them out in an adiabatic plug flow reactor packed with catalyst. And we're given inlet conditions and heat capacities. And we're given rate constants in units of liters per kilogram of catalyst per second. So the rate of reaction is going to be in moles per kilogram of catalyst per second when we multiply the rate constant by the concentration. Problem asks us to write down the equations. We don't have to solve them, but to write them down such that if we enter these into a computer, since we're not going to be able to analytically solve the system, to determine the temperature profile as a function of the cumulative catalyst weight. So we have a plug flow reactor. We're going to use weight of catalyst as our variable, so the weight zero, and we have some total weight. We don't know the size of the reactor. We want to just know how the temperature varies as a function of cumulative catalyst weight. We have A flowing in at some temperature, and of course it's going to be leaving at a different flow rate and a different temperature. So we're going to write down the mass and energy balances that we need. The molar flow rate of A with respect to the catalyst weight, the first order reaction, rate constant times the concentration. The molar flow rate of B now is involved, since B is involved in both reactions, a plus sign for the first reaction since we form B, a minus sign because we use up B, and then likewise for components C and D. So here are our four mass balances. Our initial conditions, namely at W equals zero, we need the flow rate of A. The flow rate of B initially is zero, flow rate of C, and the flow rate of D. These are all zero. We're going to have to calculate the flow rate of A, and we'll talk about that shortly. The other equation that we're going to need then is the energy balance, which is going to take the form the derivative of temperature respect to cumulative weight. Well, there's two reactions, so the rate that the first reaction takes place times the heat of reaction. And we need a minus sign here. We can think about it physically. Exothermic reaction, we expect the temperature to increase, so this term here is negative times negative. And likewise, the second reaction times its rate. And I'm going to divide this by, so when I originally wrote the energy balance, flow rate of A times heat capacity A times the temperature difference is how much energy goes to heat up the material in the reactor. And I can just use the flow rate of A because the delta Cp is zero for the reactions. If I scroll back up and look at the reactions, B going to D, B and D have the same heat capacity, so heat reaction doesn't change with temperature. That means I could just use the heat capacity of B. B plus C heat capacities equals the heat capacity of A, so I can just use the heat capacity of A to account for the energy change due to sensible heat. And I have initial conditions for this, that the temperature coming into the reactor is 400 Kelvin. Now I need some additional equations. I need the concentration for the rate expression, but I'm calculating molar flow rates, so I need to calculate concentrations of A and B since they're involved in the rate expressions. And then, of course, I'll have to enter in a bunch of variables. I won't reproduce them. I'll have to write K1 and K2. These are in function of temperature. Delta H1, delta H2, heat capacity of A. This is the only heat capacity I need. As we said earlier, we need the flow rate of A. And so we think in terms of, let's assume ideal gas is a reasonable approximation. The ideal gas law, I could write this way, volume, total number of moles. Or I could write this pressure times volume per time, volumetric flow rate, number of moles per time, a molar flow rate, total molar flow rate times RT, which means I can calculate the volumetric flow rate as this total molar flow rate, which is the four components, and I'm calculating their flow rates at any position reactor from the mass balances divided by the pressure multiplied by RT. I need this volumetric flow rate to substitute in my calculation of concentration, so I'll have to put R into the system of equations and pressure. I'm also going to use this to calculate my initial condition, FA0, pressure times the initial volumetric flow rate over RT, and the initial volumetric flow rate we're given in the problem statement is 25. Now I have all the equations that I can solve simultaneously using an equation solver for differential equations. I've entered in the various flow rates I have to calculate. The initial molar flow rate of A, we have to use this initial temperature, 400 Kelvin, initial volumetric flow rate. Pressure is constant. Of course, the gas constant is constant. But this should be a complete set of equations we can now solve to determine temperature as a function of cumulative weight in the reactor.